Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum and I'm here today at the Rock Island Auction Company taking a look at a super cool piece of American history. This is a 1799 first contract North and Cheney flintlock pistol. This is in fact the very first pistol that was actually completely manufactured on contract for the US military in the United States. Now, the reason that this was, well, the reason that this exists is because the US military, the US government, really needed guns. In fact, the country of the United States really needed guns. We, of course, had been in the middle of some various disagreements with the British. This would end up turning into the War of 1812, but back to like 1794, there were concerns that there weren't enough firearms in the United States to adequately defend the country and adequately arm militias and troops. And so even back that far, Congress actually passed a law prohibiting the export of firearms, and they allowed import of firearms without any duties or tariffs. Like anything they can do to encourage merchants to bring firearms into the U.S. They also established a national army, a national arsenal, a national armory for manufacturing firearms at Springfield. The problem was it took some time to get that going. You know, in their first year of existence, Springfield made less than 500 muskets. And for the next many years, several years at least, Springfield was primarily dedicated to making muskets, long guns, you know, standard infantry arms, which are the most important type of firearm that, you know, of many types that were needed, that was the most important, so that's what they did. But we needed more firearms. And so in an effort to supplement the production of Springfield Arsenal, Springfield Armory, in 1798, the Congress actually budgeted or allocated $800,000 in 1798 money, which is a ton of money, to purchase of weaponry. And that covered muskets, pistols, swords, still an important part of military armament. You know, the whole works. And one of the first contracts that was actually issued using some of that money was a contract to Simeon North to manufacture 500 of these pistols. They are a 69 caliber single shot flintlock pistol. And well, let me just show you what the design is on this, because in addition to being the very first of its sort of thing made in the US, it's also a pretty unique and unusual design. So the design here is fairly distinctive. It has no wooden front stock. It is, in fact, the only U.S. Marshall pistol of this type that didn't have a wooden forestock. It is 69 caliber, smoothbore, flintlock, obviously. Very nice looking, big brass frame. And if you are a connoisseur of French firearms, you might notice that this straight trigger looks rather like a French style of trigger. And that is not an accident, because the contract for these specifically called for them to be based on the French model of 1777, what they called a Charleville pistol, which I happen to have an example of here to show you, of course. And you can clearly see the similarities here. The contract actually specifically, Cheney's contract, or North's contract, specifically called for the barrel to be about an inch longer than the French pattern, which he did, of course. We have the same sort of reinforced hammer or cock up here. One of the other really kind of unusual elements of this is, and this is a little bit of flintlock nerdiness here, but the frizzen spring here has its pivot point at the back, not at the front. Not exactly earth-shattering, but very unusual for construction of pistols like this. Now, there are a number of differences between the French 1777 and the Simeon North 1799 guns, a big one being this belt clip, which we do not have on the American pistols. And then there's a little bit of difference in the exact construction of the frame down here. These guns are serialized underneath the part. So the bottom of the barrel and the top, the underside of the frame are serialized. This is number 175. And by the way, it does have a few bits that aren't entirely authentic, as one might expect after 220 years. But it is one of the nicest condition of these that is surviving. The markings on here are S. North for Simeon North and E. Cheney for Elisha Cheney of Berlin, and that's Berlin, New Hampshire. there is a little bit of a mystery as to exactly why Cheney's name is on here, because the real partnership between North and Cheney didn't start until 1810 or 1811. Probably the most reasonable hypothesis is that Cheney was acting as a financier to get North, you know, set up to manufacture 2,000 pistols. But that's not really well documented or proven. So there were, of course, two contracts of these, and I believe the differentiation is that the second contract doesn't have the first initials. And that's how you can tell them apart. The second contract just said North and Cheney, Berlin. We have a VP, meaning that this has been proofed right there, and US marked on the top of the barrel, the first of very many firearms to be manufactured for the US military that would be so marked. So the US government was so happy with these that before they'd even been all delivered, they went ahead and issued a second contract to him for another 1,500 pistols for a grand total of 2,000. They were all delivered by September of 1802, at which point Simeon North went back to his previous job of making farm implements like scythes. But just a couple years later, he would get another contract for horse pistols for the US government. And Simeon North would end up going into full-on partnership with Elisha Cheney, and they would become basically the first major pistol manufacturer in the United States. They would have a bunch of contracts with the US government, make a bunch of different models, and they would go on to be a big name. You've heard of, well, North comes up, North and his descendants come up in a number of other gun companies stretching out to the Civil War and beyond. So there are very few of these surviving. Something like less than 20 still exist, which is a little bit unusual. That's even for a pistol this old, in the United States, that's a relatively low survival rate. I've seen some suggestion that a whole bunch of these were actually destroyed in a fire in like 1810, and that might account for why they are so rare today, but don't quote me on that. I can't actually confirm it. At any rate, extremely cool, rare piece of American history here to take a look at. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you'd like to follow the Rock Island Auction Company, you can check out the description text below. I have links to their YouTube channel and their Instagram page down there where you can follow everything else that they do. Thanks for watching.